What's going on YouTube? It is Dylan Burns here, aka Animalistic, the number one health and fitness trainer for gamers. Today I'm going to be talking about how to lose weight while still gaming every single day. And yes, this is possible regardless of what anybody else tells you. Losing weight is not as hard as people make it out to be, and you can easily do it if you put your mind to it. And I promise you this, if you watch this video, you will have all the information that you need to achieve your weight loss goals in an effective and healthy way while still playing video games every single day. That being said, I'm going to explain to you the three key principles you need to know in order to lose weight, along with the number one mistake that's causing people to fail when they attempt to lose weight or get in shape. Knowing this information will allow you to not only shed the pounds quickly, but it will also allow you to keep them off for the rest of your life. And I want you to know that the third principle is very important, so you're gonna wanna stick around to hear it. But first, let me quickly explain to you the fundamentals of losing weight so you can better understand everything I'm about to tell you. We have something called a basal metabolic rate, which is essentially the amount of calories our body burns in a day to keep us going without any extra exercise or workload. When we think of calories, we can think of them as a unit of energy, kind of like a kilowatt or a kilojoule, which is why they call them kilocalories. And we can also think of the fat on our body as stored energy sources. So in order for us to gain weight, we need to be in an excess of 3,500 kilocalories over a week's period, and this will cause our body to store that extra energy as 1 pound of body fat, essentially allowing us to use that body fat later for energy. So knowing this, in order for us to lose 1 pound of body weight, we need to be in a deficit of 3,500 kilocalories a week in order for our body to have to burn the fat, which is an energy store that we have, for energy to help keep us going throughout the day. So what this means is we need to be in a calorie deficit, which means we have to be intaking less calories than our body is burning throughout the day, causing our body to take the fat storages that we have, which we know is excess energy, and burn that in order to keep us going. Knowing this, in order to find your calorie deficit, what you want to do is you go online and find a calorie calculator. This is going to give you a rough estimate of your basal metabolic rate. From there, you can take that number that it gives you and subtract 500 calories from it. Over a week span, this is going to be a 3,500 calorie deficit, which is going to allow you to burn 1 pound of stored body fat as energy for the week. You're going to want to remember this information because it's going to help you understand the three key components I will share that's going to allow you to understand how easy it really is to lose weight. So, do we want the good or the bad news first? Let's go with what my mother always says, and we'll start with the bad news. The biggest mistake that people make, and you probably are too, when trying to lose weight is restricting your eating too much. Now, yes, I know I said you need to be in a calorie deficit, but that does not mean you need to restrict your eating to the point where you're not ingesting any foods you like and you are miserable. You want to avoid cutting out the foods that you enjoy, and instead you want to learn how to portion the foods you like so that you're eating in a calorie deficit, but you are following a nutrition plan or a diet that you enjoy and something that you can stick to for the long run. This is called flexible dieting, and it is very important because losing weight isn't about a quick fix or one of those stupid ads you see that says how to lose 20 pounds in 1 month. That's a load of crap. It's about developing a healthy lifestyle and nutrition plan that you can stick to for the long run and one that's gonna keep you healthy and keep the weight off. And this cannot be achieved by going on some type of crash diet or restricting yourself from all the foods that you enjoy. Because if you remember, all you need to lose weight is to be in a deficit of 3,500 calories a week. That does not mean you have to stop eating what you enjoy, as long as it's in moderation, it's portioned properly, and a majority of your food choices are healthy. Now that the biggest mistake we make is out of the way, we'll talk about the first key component to losing weight, and that is eating in a caloric deficit. Shocker, I know. Essentially what a calorie deficit means is that you are intaking less calories than your body needs to use throughout the day, forcing your body to pull energy from your fat stores to help keep you going. And this can be achieved in two different ways. Number one, by decreasing the amount of food you're intaking by 500 calories a day. You can also try a combination of different types of deficits each day, called yo-yo dieting, and this is a good example. As long as altogether the deficit comes out to at least 3,500 calories less in the whole week. Second way to get into a calorie deficit is to increase your workload or exercise, causing your body to burn more calories than you usually do. These two options are usually best when paired together. This will ensure that your body is burning calories and fat stores at a maximum and efficient rate. With that being said, if you don't want to exercise a lot or at all, you would simply just have to restrict your eating enough and portion your food properly to keep yourself in the calorie deficit over the week in order to lose weight. So this is very doable if you just want to be playing video games for long sessions every day. However, I would highly recommend doing some sort of exercise for a minimum of 3 days a week, up to 6 days, in order to keep your body and your heart as healthy as possible. The second key component to losing weight is finding a nutrition plan that works for you. This means you need to be eating in a calorie deficit, but you need to put yourself in that calorie deficit by consuming foods that you actually enjoy, not by consuming foods that you hate because you think you need to. The best way to go about this is to learn how to portion your food, which means you should be intaking the right amount of macronutrients. A macronutrient is essentially a type of food group, and there are three different macronutrients. You have your protein sources, you have your carbohydrate sources, and you have your fat sources. Each one of these macronutrients has an essential role in your body, and you should not cut out a single one of them, regardless of what anyone else tells you. Unless, of course, you have some type of medical condition that causes you to have to cut one out, which a majority of us will not. So what that means is the keto diet and all those other fad diets are complete dog water, just like little Timmy who's on your team going 4-20 and squeaking over the mic the whole game. You wanna stay away from them. Because cutting a food group out of your diet won't make you lose weight any faster. All it's gonna do is put you into a calorie deficit. So if your deficit is already there, you will lose weight regardless of the macronutrient breakdown in your nutrition plan. A very good starting point for a macronutrient breakdown would be 50% carbs, 30% protein, and 20% fat. What you'll wanna do to make sure that you stay within your calorie deficit is download a food tracking app like MyFitnessPal. And whenever you eat, you need to weigh your food using a food scale in order to make sure that you are getting the right amount of food and the right portions of food to keep you in your calorie deficit. So if you download an app like MyFitnessPal, you calculate your calorie deficit using an online calorie calculator. All you need to do is track what you eat in the day, make sure you don't go over your calculated calorie intake, and you'll start to lose weight at a steady and healthy rate. MyFitnessPal will also give you a macronutrient breakdown, so as you become accustomed to tracking your food, you can begin to better tailor your macros, fit the percent ranges above while still staying in your calorie deficit. And lastly but not least, the third and most important key component to losing weight is a mindset switch. I bet you're wondering, Dylan, what the hell does that even mean? Well, I'm glad you asked. It means you need to change the way you view yourself, along with the way that you view food and the way that you view your ability to lose weight and, most importantly, keep it off. First, you need to stop viewing yourself as someone who is overweight and lazy. Instead, you need to accept that that's who you used to be so that you can move past it and now see and talk about yourself as someone who is healthy, in shape, and eat properly to take care of their body and their health. Secondly, you need to view food not as something bad for you, but the cause of why you're overweight. Instead, you need to look at it as something that fuels your body and something that you need in order to survive and strive, which means you need to accept that your eating habits were the problem, not the food. And you also don't want to look at any certain food as inherently bad or something that you need to stay away from. Instead, you need to look at it as something that you could have, but you choose not to. This will allow you to feel like you have more freedom and also allow you to develop self-discipline, which is very important. The reason for this is if we tell ourselves we can't have something, we're gonna want it way more. So that would not be the best course of action. And lastly, you need to stop looking and thinking about losing weight as something that's impossible or something that you can't do. Instead, you need to look at it as something that is possible and something that you are doing. Because if we start off any type of conversation or attempt to do anything with the thought or belief that it's not even possible, well then it will indeed be impossible. Remember, our biggest obstacle is our own mind, and it is truly the only thing standing in your way from achieving the healthy life and body that you want. Which means, come here, come a little closer, I'll tell you. You need to stop saying that I can't, and instead start saying, watch me. Listen everyone, I really hope that video helped. If you've learned anything or found some value in this video, please consider dropping a like and hitting that subscribe button along with the bell notification so you can stay up to date on any videos that I'm putting out. And also, if you have any questions or there's any topics you'd like me to make a video about, please leave a comment down below and I will try my best to help or make a video on it if it is something that I am able to speak on. So thank you all for watching and hopefully I'll see you in the next one.